Right, I'm going to do a walkthrough of how to build a web chat client, right, in Rails 5. So I already ran Rails new lab chat, that's the name of the project, using PostgreSQL. Let's go ahead and set it up. I already ran git init and git add. So right now I have one commit. The next step is to add Bootstrap to our project. We'll add a few more gem very soon. We know that first step with Bootstrap is to remove the CSS file and change it to SCSS. I'm going to include the all the CSS files manually. I don't use the required tree down here. All right, let's also generate a home controller, and we will create a root URL that point to it. Okay, so I think we have some basic stuff set up. We just create the database and start the server. I'm going to the application layout and start putting some bootstrappy stuff in there. Naturally, having a nav bar will be nice, so we'll add a nav bar quickly. All of this stuff is familiar to us by now. So here's the navbar stuff. Very soon, I don't need these links. Let's see what we have. All right. So on home, that's okay. I think that looks fine enough. So let's start following the features. Okay, so we add a message. Now we decide to whether to do a one room chat or multiple room. Let's start a basic one room chat. Users can send a message, right? Rails generate model. So we'll send a basic message model, set up message model with content. Let's just have it as content be large, but we'll use a small text box for now. And I think that's it. Maybe we can set up the IP address or the user as username, so we can see who is who. So let's have, unfortunately on localhost IP isn't a good way to demonstrate, so let's use username for now. So I have a message model, I definitely need to migrate. Now let's create the chat room. To keep things simple, I'm going to do the chat room right in here. So there's only one chat room for now. We can improve it over time. So imagine we have a text box, right? And let's see how we can implement this. We have a messages controller to create message. And all right, I'm going to display the chat messages in a form. So we will have just messages In each one of them, we'll just display the list of messages like this. And in each one, we'll just display netmessage.content. Now we have a form for new message. And it's a text field content. And potentially it's just a text field username as well. So we will just put them on the same, in the same line. Okay, so let's see how it looks. Obviously this will crash right now and we'll need to set up the variable. Let's get all the messages. Excuse me. Message.new. Excuse me. All right. Now we need to set up the route for message.new to work. Resources, messages. In order to have this, we should do Rails generate controller messages, right? I should have done a Rails generate resource, but that's okay. All right, so it will look like this, and if I have message create content first, I should be able to see first here. That's great. Just implement the logic of creating a message. So we have messages create, and we're just following the convention here. Very simple. We permit username and content. So we do message create. Now you can do that if you know a message is able to create. If some of you don't like this, you can do new and then you save here. All right, it's the same thing. So let's see if it can save, then we will just display message save. I think it's quite obvious, so just keep it really simple. Normally, you know, when you implement chat room, then redirect to chat room instead of a root path. We only have one chat room for now, so it's the same actually. In this case, pretty much, maybe I'll just display an error. Let's add some validation to message here. Validate content. I think that should be enough. And so if you start creating, hello, press enter. We need their form to actually be able to submit. So we need a submit button in there. Let's make it clearer. That looks nice enough. Let's make it a little bootstrappy. Same thing, form control. Down here, maybe that's nicer. Now, if I enter new things, that each of these will be in a message format. So I have these guys. This is in each message. Now by now you know that we should put this in a partial. So I'm going to do that. Put it in, extract this into a partial. It's a message partial. Now notice the message partial, but I accidentally put it in the safe, in the home folder. That's not the convention, so let's move it. Let's move it to messages. Okay, so when you do, now you can say it's go to messages / message with a variable message. This is the long way, right? Or you can just say vendor message and it does the same thing. Now, let's try it. It still works, and obviously these three lines can be simpler, right? We simplify it with vendor messages like this. So if we just start sending messages, hello, sounds good. Now we need to display the username as well. And then let's say if there's no username, then this is like anonymous. But sometimes this is okay, but it's cleaner if I have a username or default logic in here, right? Username dot or anonymous. Anonymous. That looks cool. Now, the username, technically I shouldn't be able to store the username every time. So maybe I can store the username in the session. Let's just leave it there for now. And so let's check the list of user stories we need to do. Alright, cannot submit an empty message. Alright, we need to display chat messages. I have introduced this in lab 2, so I'm going to just copy that method. We have flash messages, we can display them on. Maybe I'll just display them right here, right? Flash messages. If flash happens to exist, then we get the error right here. Of course, you can also make the form a little bit stricter. So this one, maybe you can put a required true. And certain browsers require this. On Chrome, it doesn't require it, so it doesn't work all the time. Having backend validation is important. All right. So this seems fine. Now we're going to use JavaScript to implement how to make this response faster. So let's do that next.